Thank you, Paolo, for this very kind introduction. I would like to thank Moises Cohen for his absolutely marvelous Mervelarosa hospitality. And it's a great pleasure to share some ideas about this knee ligament injury with you in football. I am working in a university hospital, and I have no conflict of interest in this presentation. I would like to tell you that I took some ideas from these different documents, and particularly last week when we were in Madrid with UEFA, and also some publications that were presented recently. Also, I used some data from the ACL registry from Sweden, and the data are from 2012. As you know, football is very popular. There is many males that practice, but also many females that are practicing soccer or football. And this is very frequent to observe some injury and knee injury. As you can see, up to one-fifth of the football injury are knee ligament injury. I will focus mainly on MCL, a few seconds, and on ACL injury. And I think we will discuss the PCL injuries later on concerning the goalkeeper injury. And in fact, the question is when a patient has some knee injury, the first one is the frequency of this injury and also the return to play of the player. In fact, the MCL injury is the most frequent and the most common injury, and it occurs mainly during the game, the match, much more during training. And also what we observe that over the last years, according to the UEFA registry, there is less and less MCL injury that occur. The mean delay to return to play after an MCL injury is 23 days. And I just want to highlight this fact on this busy slide. You can see this is the MCL injury ranked as the fifth more frequent injury. And here you can see the median of delay to return to sport is 16 days and the average 23 days. There is one injury that is particularly frequent in a soccer player, and I want to show you this kind of lesion. This is a lesion of the deep MCL, and in this case, it can lead to consider the surgery. And Andy Williams really highlights this fact, and you know that the MCL is a very complex structure with different layers. And this is, in fact, this upper part of the MCL that is frequently injured. And in this case, one can consider the injury. In all the other cases, this is mainly a conservative treatment that is proposed to the player. So as we say that the ACL injury can occur also during the game and the match, and it's not so frequent. It represents less than 5% of all-time loss injury, and this is independent of the level of the players. The annual prevalence of ACL injury is reported to be between 0.5 and 6% of all female players, and it's a little bit less in male players. In female, we can observe 2 to 3 times more ACL injury compared to male. And as you can see, this is not very well defined if it's happened on the kicking leg or the supporting leg. It seems that it's more frequent in the supporting leg when we consider female. In fact, some data are different in the French observation. If we consider the ACL, we can highlight the fact this is a very severe injury. And when we consider the different severe injury, according to the UEFA data, it seems to be the most severe injury. And when a patient has ACL rupture, it took around 6 months to return to the field. If we now consider what they found in the ACL registry in Sweden, you see here that the football is the most frequent cause for ACL rupture. And the second is alpine skiing, and probably in my city in Lyon, close to the Alps, it's the ratio is a little bit different. Whatever, we can focus on these two columns, and you can see that there is a more ACL rupture that were operated on male since 2010, and than in female, and the ratio is about the same in 2010, 11, and 12. So this is a frequent thing. But this lesion is not so frequent, and it's why we need some register to record and to analyze this type of lesions. And they did that under the direction of Jan Engström in the UEFA, and you see here how they can collect among 18,000 injuries, only 100 ACL ruptures. So it's not a frequent lesion, but it's a very severe lesion. There is some reason that can explain the onset of or the event of an ACL rupture, like the fact there is some regional difference in Europe, and for example, it's more frequent in the Mediterranean country than in the northern country. Also, what we can say about the management of this lesion, that if we treat a patient conservatively, is a level as, of course, a high risk to decrease. So to maintain the same level, it's now obvious that it's much better to operate the patient and to perform an ACL reconstruction. We have different options in terms of techniques. And surgery at our favor, we prefer to operate a patient when the knee is calm, not at the acute phase. We prefer to use the BTB. We, in this is our personal choice, prefer the out-in technique, but I think the in-out technique is a good option too. We prefer to use one bundle. We prefer the AM approach, and also we don't like to have a very early return to sport. But this is some option that can be modified by the team that treats the patient, and this is still open. This is the old logo of the FIFA, and I need a new one to include in this presentation. I was very happy to listen to this in the Conference of Madrid organized by Michel Doug and the UEFA, because this is exactly what said Enrique Jones, and this is the option we choose for many years in our department. There is an apparent consensus in top football players, including female, to use bone patellar tendon bone, to use also a single band, to use interferential screw, and also a personalized rehabilitation program. So this is probably a choice. Nobody knows what is the best, but it seems that there is some consensus in the world of football for that. We use a technique described by Henri Dejour a very long time ago. Since 1978, we adapted the technique to the arthroscopy, and in few cases, particularly in chronic cases, not at the acute phase, we can add an extra-articular augmentation. So the results of this surgery are very good, and it was very well analyzed by Walden and published in the literature. And as you can notice, if we consider the elite football player, most of them are able to return to sports at a very high level. In fact, almost all the elite players were operated on, 97%, and among them, 94% were able to return to sports. So this is excellent results. And why the results are so good in this very limited population? It's probably due to some personal motivation, economical reason, and also because they are very well treated. When a lesion occurs to an elite player, the time to diagnosis is very short, and immediately he gets a clinical exam, MRI, and all he needs. Also, the surgery is usually performed 3 to 5 weeks after the injury, and always the best surgeon takes care of this patient. And the rehabilitation is also optimized, and the physio too, and very individualized, and probably this is also one of the reasons of the success. When to decide to allow the player to return to the field and to be on the pitch, it's not so simple, and there is many different possibilities. We can test the strength of the muscle using isokinetic evaluation. We can use MRI to follow the aspect of the graft, but we can also very simple test, and there is a different type of evaluation according probably also to the level of this player. Whatever, if the patient is able to return to sport, are we able to control the onset of osteoarthritis? And probably the consideration is different for elite player and a regular player, I would say, but in any case, from a medical point of view, the return to sports is not always a good option for the knee. It could be a very good option for the patient, for the player, but for the knee, it can lead to some knee abuse. And there is no real evidence in literature to support the fact that the ACL reconstruction will prevent the onset of osteoarthritis. So the reason to operate this patient is mainly to allow them to return to sports. There is different data that support this consideration, and you can see that in some Swedish cohort, they found that males are likely to develop some osteoarthritis, whatever the management, conservative or surgical management. And the same findings were reported in literature by Lemander concerning female. So we can treat this patient, we are not sure to prevent osteoarthritis. And this osteoarthritis, this onset of osteoarthritis, is correlated to the status of the meniscus. So the idea is to preserve the meniscus and to operate the patient before he develops meniscal lesions. And we were able in a few years ago to report our results with a very long-term follow-up in the AGSM, and we found that the onset of osteoarthritis is directly correlated to the status of the meniscus. In literature, we can find the same type of data, and you see here, if we consider the here patient with a normal meniscus at surgery, you can see the rate of osteoarthritis. This is between around 10%, between 5 and 20, and when there is a partial meniscectomy at time of surgery, the rate of osteoarthritis at follow-up is much more high. So we need to prevent this ACL injury. And to prevent this, there is different programs that were proposed in the past by CARAFA and more recently by FIFA with program 11 plus. And there is many publication in literature indicating that it's really useful to do this time of prevention. And this is interesting not only for the patient but also for the team, for the coach, because there is a direct correlation between the injury prevention and the chance of success for a team. So if the patient had no injury, the team will get better results. And this is why it's particularly interesting also to use this kind of program, particularly in younger patients. And in this situation, we can avoid the rupture of the ACL. And again, there is some data in literature you can find and that support this concept. And this is a picture we did during the celebration of the 25th century of Michel Doug in Bruges. And also this is something we can consider just before this World Cup, because there were some publications that show that if a player is too much involved in some high-level games before the World Cup, he has a high risk to develop an injury. So for our French team, I hope that they will not be selected in many European Cup before the World Cup, so that they will be present during the next game in Brazil. So to conclude, ACL injury in soccer player is commonly treated surgically. and good clinical results with return to play at the same elite level can be expected, but evolution to osteoarthritis does not seem to be prevented by ACL reconstruction. In the next seconds, I just want to tell you I'm really happy that Isakos has excellent relationship with FIFA. This is something particularly nice for us. And we had the opportunity to discuss this many times, particularly in Toronto, and I hope we will continue this fantastic relationship. Thank you.